The videos you are currently seeing are generated by a new model called Holocine. The biggest feature of this model is its ability to generate narrative videos with a cinematic quality. Technically speaking, it employs many unique implementation methods. Firstly, it is a universal framework, meaning this method can be applied not just to a specific model, it can even be generalized to various models. Furthermore, it has a built-in sliding window, which allows it to generate ultra-long videos. Additionally, it uses a method of unified scene setting, which ensures that elements within the various scenes remain completely consistent during scene transitions. We can also see from its official examples that its capability in generating multi-scene, ultra-long videos is indeed very strong. Of course, I have also conducted numerous tests on this model to analyze its advantages and disadvantages. What you are seeing now is the Holocene page on GitHub. First, we can see that the released model currently has both the full and sparse versions. If we want to use it within ComfyUI, there are two different options. The first is to use the Kijai One video extension. The second is an extension developed specifically for this model by another developer. If you use the Kijai version, remember to upgrade the extension to the latest version and download the corresponding model. You can download the corresponding models using this URL address. It currently offers high noise and low noise models. I have also built a workflow on Running Hub. You can access the platform via runninghub.ai in the ComfyUI space. Running Hub is an excellent online workbench. Whenever new extensions and models appear, it follows up immediately. You can register for Running Hub using the invitation link in my video description. This grants you 1,000 free credits. Additionally, you receive 100 bonus credits every day you log into Running Hub, allowing you to try out your own workflows. If you want to use this model in ComfyUI, the most complicated part is actually writing the prompts. We can look at the official examples, where we see keywords like global caption, character, and per s hot caption. Therefore, the prompts cannot be written arbitrarily. Regarding the rules for writing prompts, there is a very clear explanation provided here. There are two methods for using prompts. The first method is structured prompting. The other type is the raw string format. In this case, your raw string must follow a specific format. The keywords here include the first is global caption, which represents our global prompt. Generally, this describes the overall environment and characters within the scene. The other is called per s hot caption. This marks the beginning of a new shot, representing a separate prompt for each subsequent shot. Note that the per s hot caption is immediately followed by the prompt for the first shot. Once you understand this structure, writing the prompt should not be too difficult, although it might be somewhat tedious. Next, let's briefly look at the workflow. First, note that this workflow is a standard Wang 2.2 text-to-video T2V workflow. Let's briefly review the model loading. Here we have the Holocene high noise model and low noise model. However, pay attention to the acceleration LoRa. Try to choose the 2.1 version, not the 2.2 version. The overall performance of 2.2 is not particularly good. Therefore, I chose a rank 256 2.1 acceleration LoRa. So these two are the same. Additionally, to ensure the aesthetic quality of the generated video, I added a feedback model here. This is consistent with the theory we discussed previously. For the high noise model, we added the MPS feedback model. For the low noise model, we added the HPS feedback model. Furthermore, I set the weights for both to 0.5. Then we have our encoder and our VAE. Following that is the prompting section. Note that the prompt I pasted here is relatively complex. Finally, we have the sampling section. This part is no different from traditional T2V, so I won't go into detail. Let's focus on my resolution. I used a resolution of 832 by 480. The number of frames is 241 frames. Please note that in the Holocene model, the length of all frames, whether the total number of frames or the frames per shot, must adhere to the 4N1 principle. If this rule is not followed, errors might occur. Therefore, be mindful when setting the frame count. I used 8 steps for sampling, and the algorithm used is LCM. As a result, we get a fantastic effect. As you can see, the overall appearance of the characters is very beautiful. This is a video with 241 frames. Of course, you cannot simply state the duration because that is related to the frame rate. Now let's look at how to write the prompts. I attempted two methods for writing the prompts. The first method was using qwn3vl to write the prompts. I kept the node here. However, based on my tests, qwn3vl did not perform particularly well in this scenario. This is because it is only a 7B model. The model parameters dictate its capability. In fact, you will notice that the prompt structure for this model involves many implicit rules. For instance, we need to clearly specify the total number of shots, and the actual number of shots must match the declared quantity. This involves a lot of inferential content. Overall, QEE3VL did not perform very well in testing. Therefore, I still recommend using a larger model, such as Gemini, to generate the corresponding prompts. Similarly, I generated the corresponding prompt engineering files for everyone available in both Chinese and English. How to use it? I will use the English version as an example. You can open AI Studio and create a new session. Be sure to select the Gemini 2.5 Pro model. Then, in the system instruction section, the system prompt, paste the file content. Below, you can set a theme, or if you prefer not to write a theme, you can upload a favorite image. It can help you generate the corresponding prompts. For example, if I simply write a beautiful woman riding a horse, we will receive a prompt that conforms to the required format. Of course, you can also upload a preferred image, and it will generate the corresponding content based on that image. Look, they are all the same. You just need to copy your prompt to this location. I tested nearly 20 examples. Then, I selected a few representative cases. Let's quickly review them so you can get a feel for the model. Let's start with two oriental scenes. Note that this one describes a scene of the Dunhuang flying Apsaras. This model shows very strong capability in rendering oriental elements. The character's clothing, hairstyle, and the overall environment are completely consistent with the Dunhuang flying Apsaras concept. The second example is a scene I set up of a beautiful woman dancing on a huge rock. Pay attention to the camera cuts. Although they are not extremely obvious, we can still see the effect of the shot transitions in the middle. This is a close-up shot that we tested. Here, we find the realism of the character to be very strong. She is looking at an old photo. However, in this case, the sense of separate shots is not particularly obvious. It seems to be a one-shot video. This is another test, featuring a Western character, a beautiful elf hunting in the jungle. We also set up 5 different shots, but you will notice that it also appears to be a single continuous shot, with no switching in the middle. However, the overall narrative sense and duration are fine. This is the example we just showed you. Likewise, you will find that this is a single continuous shot video. Perhaps there was an issue with how I wrote the prompt, as it failed to capture the idea of distinct shots. However, based on our test results, there is a high probability that it will produce a one-shot video. This example, however, is better. It features several shot transition effects. Take a look. This one also has a few camera cuts. Based on these examples, let's summarize in the Wang 2.2 implementation. This model is capable of generating either continuous one-shot videos or videos with multiple shots. This entirely depends on whether your prompt can effectively convey the concept of distinct shots. Regardless, this model performs well in terms of generated video quality, duration, and character consistency. What are you waiting for? Go try it yourself. Follow me to become someone who understands AI.